Milwaukee aldermen say put the blame where it belongs after three people were killed by suspects fleeing police.
New at 6, 12 News, Kent Wainscott is live in the WISN.com center. And Kent, one city leader is trying to clear the air about some recent remarks.
The president of Milwaukee's Common Council is adamantly defending the police department and its chief today after what he calls misinformation over the weekend, suggesting that he wanted a new investigation of police chase procedures.
They happened just one day and 1 mile apart. Two tragic crashes. Three people died when hit by suspects fleeing from police. Jacqueline Littlejohn's 23-year-old son, Don Hamilton, was one of the victims.
That's my baby, and somebody took my baby away from me. You know, they have to take my baby.
In both incidents, the drivers ran red lights before slamming into other vehicles. Police say in one case they had stopped their chase several blocks before the fatal crash, and in the other had barely begun their pursuit.
I firmly support the police department, and I have no reason to believe that they handled it or acted irresponsibly.
Following the crashes, Common Council President Willie Hines had reportedly said he would call for an investigation of police chase procedures. But today, Hines told 12 News he spoke with Chief Ed Flynn and wants to make it clear that he's not criticizing the department.
He said that they will examine the incident, and I am asking for an inquiry. And I'm in concurrent with the chief. I agree with him that it should be examined, but by no means am I putting blame on the chief. I am, or the police department.
Alderman Bob Donovan is also defending the officer, saying the blame belongs with the suspects.
What concerns me is that the mentality of some, apparently, to immediately look at the police while, you know, not looking at the real culprits of this, which are the malcontents, the individuals that are running from the police for whatever reason.
Now, Chief Ed Flynn didn't comment on the incidents today, but in a statement over the weekend, he said a preliminary investigation shows that the officers followed procedure and acted appropriately. A full review is underway, Toya.
And Ken, what about the suspects who were fleeing from police?
Well, the two suspects in the Friday crash, an 18-year-old and a 16-year-old, are in custody. And in the other crash, the driver has been arrested, but police say they're still searching for other suspects. No charges have been filed in either of the crashes as of yet.
All right, Kent, thank you.